Hello friends, we will be covering imperial law in this. Imperial law is an alternative form of Bio Savart law. Okay, so here we will be covering again some of the same points like what will be the magnetic field in a straight wire, what will be the magnetic field in circular law, and also we will cover solenoids, toroids. And parallel plate currents and torque on a current loop. Now let's first understand what happens is in case we have a say conductor of length dl. So our line integral magnetic field for the closed loop will be B into dl. If B is the intensity of the magnetic field, then it will be our line integral of magnetic field for the closed loop will be B dot EL, which will be equal to the current that is flowing in the conductor. Now, whenever electric or magnetic field are formed, space cuts it down. Space cuts it down means there is a permittivity, some of it gets deducted. How much? So we can say B dot dl will be equal to mu. Okay, so mu is the space cut. So the whole current cannot become the magnetic field. Mu I. Okay, so we derive onto this formula. By this formula, we can say an ampere is a unit to measure the rate of electric flow or current in an electrical conductor. 1 ampere of current represents 1 coulomb of electric charge moving past a specific point in 1 second. Okay. To calculate Imperial's law, what we have to do, we have to consider 4 steps. The 4 steps will be consider a ampere loop. That will be the first. The second step will be calculate the left side, which is B dot dl. Calculate I going through the loop, which will be on the right side, and then finally applying the imperial law formula mu I. Imperial law can be used to find magnetic field of many objects, such as magnetic field due to long straight current carrying coil conductor. We have derived all these formulas using these two formulas by using Bio Savart. We are using imperial law, and to find out the values, we will be using these 4 steps all the time, just like Gaussian theorem, right? Then we will be doing solenoid. Imperial law can be used to find a magnetic field for solenoid, for toroid, and for parallel plates, and then torque on the coil. Okay, so what we have to do, just like Gauss theorem, we will use the 4 steps process. Step 1 will be to consider an ampere loop. That will be the step 1. That includes the point where we want to calculate the magnetic field. Okay, so here we have taken a wire as current carrying coil. Okay, so this is the current carrying conductor, the wire which is taking the current up. We want to find out the magnetic field at this point, P. This is at a distance R from the wire. Okay. So if we want to find out this, so what we have to do, we have to then calculate left side. What is the left side? B dot dl. Here, what will be the dl? Dl will be, we have to take a loop, right? So this is a circular loop. So in this loop, dl will be 2 pi r. So we will write b dot 2 pi r. Then we will have to equate the two. So b dot 2 pi r equals to mu I. What is the I? I is the current that is flowing through this wire. So bringing b, keeping b on one side, b will be equal to mu I by 2 pi r. To calculate magnetic field at 3 points of a conductor, that is outside, on the surface, and on the axis, we are considering this as a conductor. Okay, this complete cylinder that you can see is a conductor. Now, we want to find out the magnetic field at the three points in case the test charge is placed here at P, in case it's placed here at the surface, and in case it is placed here in the center, maybe somewhere here or wherever this is placed. Now, when P is outside, same line wire, whatever formula that we have derived, in case it's placed here, the line wire formula, which we learned in the last slide, that is B is equal to mu I by 2 pi R, mu I by 2 pi R. Where have we derived this? In the previous slide here. So this B is equal to mu I 2 pi R will be applicable. So in case P is outside the conductor, in case P is on the surface, if this point is placed here on the surface, what is this point? The test charge is placed here on the surface. Then this small r has to be replaced by the capital R. The small r was where the distance from the center all the way down to the point. And the capital R is the radius of this conductor. So here we have to replace the small r with the capital R. Now, if P is on the axis, that is on this line, if it has been placed, then the magnetic field at this point will be zero. We are considering one more case wherein the point is in between the conductor somewhere here. In that case, by unitary method, what we have to do, this will be like, if this is the distance, then this will be pi r square, and the complete will be like from here all the way to this point will be pi r square, which is the capital R. Okay, this will be the small r. So we are, by the unitary method, we can say the value of the current will be I by pi r square into pi r square. Okay, so here we can write I r square by r square. Applying the imperial law, we know B dot dl equals to mu I. The value for mu I will be put this, which will be mu. The value for I will be I r square by r square. Here r, what is r? Again, r is in case in this conductor, this is where, somewhere inside the conductor it has been placed, but not on the surface. It's not equal to the capital R. So that time the current is not full. By unitary methods, the current is going to be I square by r square. So we are going to write mu I r square by r square. And what is the dl distance here? 2 pi r. So 2 pi r is whatever distance we are covering, this part be 2 pi r, wherever that point is kept. Okay. So this, when we equate these two and subtracting one, cancelling out one r with the square r here, so we are left with a value mu I r by 2 pi r square. If you notice here, r is directly proportional to the magnetic field B. So in the graphical representation, the area in between, because here it is zero, we know P on the point, if the test charge is on the axis, absolutely on the axis, that time it's zero. In gradually it keeps increasing because it's directly proportional to R. B is directly proportional to R. This is where it's coming from. This is maximum. Magnetic field is maximum at the surface and it keeps reducing down. B inversely proportional to 1 R because this is the formula. B is equal to mu I by 2 pi R as long as it's outside the conductor. So it's coming down. A solenoid is a wire. Okay, if we wound a wire like this, like the same wire is wound down, this becomes a solenoid. So solenoid is a wire wound closely in the form of a helix. It's the shape of a helix. To calculate magnetic field inside a solenoid, so what will be the magnetic field here inside the solenoid? Let us draw a rectangle LMNO. So why are we drawing the LMNO? Because our first step is to make an imperial loop. So the loop here will be this LMNO. It is a perfect square that we are taking. Now we get four parts, which is B dot dl, M to L, which will be this M to L, plus b dot dl n to m, so this will be the n to m, b dot dl o to n, so this will be o to n, and b dot dl lo, so lo will be here. These are the upper limits and the lower limits, so we get this part. Okay, now if you see for nm and for on, for ol, for ol and nm, these, the cos theta is 90 degree. When cos theta is 90 degree, so what happens, the value becomes 0. Okay, and for on, if we consider the line on, there is no current flowing through this. The line on is parallel to the solenoid, hence parallel to the magnetic field inside the solenoid, and it doesn't have the current flowing through. So we can believe that the magnetic field here is also 0. Now we are left with only this, Lm. So B, Lm, DL. Rest all becomes 0 plus 0 plus 0. So we get B, say L, BL equals to, what is the normal value? It's always BL is equal to mu I. But since it's a solenoid with number of turns, so we are going to write N, and there will be a particular length of this solenoid, so we have to write L. So L is for the length of the solenoid, N is the number of the turns the wire has taken. So B is equal to mu NI. Now we are covering up toroid. Toroid is a solenoid again, and it is like a solenoid bend together. Okay, so if a solenoid is bent in a circular shape and the ends are joined, we get a toroid. So we get a toroid if this solenoid, which is a wrap of the, which is like a wrap. Okay, so if the ends are joined together of the solenoid, we get a toroid. We will be considering three cases here. P1 is when this is outside. P2 will be inside, and P3 is passing through the concentric circle. So in case we place a test charge here at P1, here at P2, or here at P3, what will be the value of the magnetic field? Step 1, let's consider an imperial loop, which is a concentric circle passing through P, where center of toroid and the circle are same. Now we are first, we are taking when P1 is outside. When we are placing it outside here, we are taking this. We are cutting it down like this. Okay, from the center. This was the complete toroid. Here we are taking this point here and we are cutting this down in this form. In the plane of imperial loop is considered the net current through the loop is 0. How is it 0? If you see current coming from this side, on the blue one that you can see, will be positive, and this will be going downwards, so this will be negative. So this minus in and out current, current entering in is equal to current coming out, so B dot dl will be equal to 0. This is because the way we have cut this toroid. Okay, we are considering case 2. P2 is inside, this point is inside. So draw an imperial loop. We have just drawn imperial loop, which is a concentric circle passing through P2 here. Now current through loop, in this loop, there is no current. So I is 0. So B dot dl is equal to 0. So what is the magnetic field at this point? B will be equal to 0. Now our case 3, which is P3 is passing through concentric circle. That is, suppose this is my toroid and it is just here. Okay, so how are we going to cut it? Let us consider imperial loop, concentric circle passing through P3. How are we making this concentric circle? Like this. See, this is another concentric circle which is cutting this point P, but instead of cutting from here, in the previous we have cut it from here, we are making concentric circle and cutting this toroid in this form. So means this element, which you can see in the darker red, gets eliminated. Only this inner part of the toroid is left with us. Now B is perpendicular to the current loop. So imperial loop is also making concentric circle. So cos 0 it will be 1. Okay. So we have first is B dot dl. So dl value will be 2 pi r. Current passing through loop. Here, what is the second step? We have to see what is the, we have calculated B dot dl, that is 2 pi r. Here we are considering the r as from this point, the center to the here. Okay, so this is to calculate B dot dr. Here dl is equal to 2 pi r. To calculate current I, number of turns in toroid are say n. The shape is circular. So circumference is again 2 pi r for this also. So here the difference is the current will be number of turns. So area, that the circumference, that is 2 pi r into n. The total current will become this 2 pi r n times into I. This will be our current. And B dot dl is B 2 pi r equals to, this current value is coming down, which will be mu 2 pi r n into I. So B will become, we strike out 2 pi and r gets cancelled from this end, from the left side and from the right side, and we are left with B is equal to mu n I. Force between two parallel current. Okay, so here the expression for force between two parallel current carrying wires. This is wire 1 which is carrying current, and this is wire 2 which is carrying current. So wire 1 will also make a magnetic field like this, which is going to make an impact on the other one. Similarly, this will also make an impact here on the magnetic field on the wire 2. So we are trying to find out what will be the force on the wire 2 by wire 1 because of the magnetic field developed like this. So consider two long parallel wires. Current flowing through them is I1 and I2. Let R be the separation between them. We are measuring the force I2, while I1 will generate the magnetic field. So this is generating a magnetic field. Rings on top are showing the magnetic field generated by, this is showing the magnetic field generated by I1. So F21 means force on. How do we read this? F21 will be read as force on 2 by 1. Will be equal to, what is the formula in terms of current for force is ILB, in terms of, in force otherwise is QVB. So here we are going to take the formula, force is equal to ILB, and the magnetic field B1 for a normal current carrying loop is mu I by 2 pi R, right? The current, the wire, the magnetic field by B1, the wire B1. So here the magnetic field will be this much. Putting this value in this formula here, so we get F21 is equal to I2L mu I1 by 2 pi R. Okay, bringing down I2 and I1 together, writing it in form this form, mu I1 I2 by L by 2 pi R. We can say this value, force to 1, will become this formula. This is force per unit length. Per unit, this will be the force between the two parallel currents. Okay. Now we are considering torque here. Torque experienced by a current loop in a uniform magnetic field. This is a north pole of a magnet. This is the south pole of a magnet, and the magnetic field has been formed in between them. Now consider a rectangular coil. What is this? It's a rectangular coil, matlab a wire which has been wrapped. Okay. So in, we have named it as PQRS. So this is, consider a rectangular coil PQRS suspended in a uniform magnetic field B with its axle perpendicular to the field. This axle is absolutely perpendicular to the field. Current I flowing through coil, this, there is a current which is flowing through this coil, PQRS, the length, this is the length of the coil, and this is the breadth of the coil, PQRS. So the area is length into the breadth. So that we know. Theta is the angle between the direction of magnetic field. This is the direction of the magnetic field and the normal. So if we look at the top view, which is this QR, this is the top view. If we consider the move the camera on the top and see it from the top, say this is at QR. These lines are representing the magnetic field. So then this angle theta is between the direction of the magnetic field, which is this magnetic field, and the normal to the plane of the coil. Okay. So magnetic force on the sides here, this side, this one, and which is QR and PS will cancel out. But this QP and RS are in opposite direction. This is the direction of the force, and the force direction is on the other side. That is the reason torque is being formed. Torque is twisting force that tends to cause the rotation. The symbol for torque is this. So torque is force into normal distance between forces. So QN is the normal distance between force. So this is the QN, which is the normal distance between force. So force into QN becomes our formula for torque. What is the value of Q in terms of theta? We know sine theta equals to QN by QR from this triangle. Okay. And the value for QN will be QR sine theta. What is QR? This. What is QR? QR is the width of what? Of this coil, this width. This is W. So we get W sine theta. Torque is equal to force. Instead of writing force, we can write the formula ILB. ILB into W sine theta. Here W and L will become I. Instead of writing L into W, length into width, we can write area IAB from the magnetic field sine theta. So this becomes a formula for the torque. Here I have written down all the formulas for you so that you can note down all these formulas that we have derived in this video and the previous. These are the Biot-Savart ones, these are the Imperial laws, and these are the other values of R, V, T that we have taken out. You can write down these two. I hope this session was helpful to you. Thank you.